echoes in the deep, all will repeat, yeah. Through night and the day, I'll find my way.
Thank you. I guess one way to look at the day, today is the day of challenge, where we're going to be challenged by our new views of Saturn. I think it's fair to say that everything we're seeing today will be new.
One can see the enormous amount of structure that's up at the very, very high latitudes. Some of these complex features, this brown spot that we've been looking at quite recently, now taking on morphology very similar to a spiral galaxy. Well, there's an enormous amount of detail that's beginning to show up, and we expected this. This approach to Saturn with Voyager 2 giving us a good high-resolution view down on the illuminated ring system. Early in the approach by Voyager 1, we had estimated that there were hundreds of rings, and by the time we got through, that estimate grew up to perhaps something like 1,000.
Thank you. distant vantage point. The Earth might not seem of any particular interest. But for us, it's different. Consider again that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. Thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king and peasant, every mother and father, hopeful child, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors, so that in glory and triumph they could become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Our posturings, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this point of pale light. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic dark. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that help will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. Like it or not, for the moment, the Earth is where we make our stand.
first in the history of exploration. The most distant human-made object, NASA's Voyager 1 spacecraft, is in interstellar space. The 36-year-old probe is now sailing the uncharted waters of a new cosmic sea. And it has brought us along for the journey.